get a hit.
Lefty partnership comes up on the board with that single. Richard Snell to Mark Crowe, then swing again. That was up in the air, but it was just wide of gully. Diving Epstein, one down to third man.
Well, this is not Crowe at his best by any means, but all you can say, it's a sign of a real class player if he can struggle and survive and still collect a few runs. Eventually things will come right for him, but...
this time, and an appeal from the South Africans. Was it for LBW? I can hardly believe it. He was down the wicket. Maybe felt they got an inside edge onto the pad, and Hudson took the rolling catch and slip.
Crowe got into a real tangle. More credit to Eckstein for inducing this. Opened him up, beat the bat. Clearly, completely beat the bat. Far from classical, but very effective.
And Crowe decides that he's going to go over the top now if it's up to him. And a much more confident shot from Martin Crowe. And four runs to the long off boundary, and that's Martin Crowe's 50. And he's 18th in Test match cricket. Incredible that he's got 1700s to go with it.
Also brings up the 100 partnership. And to me, ominously for South Africa, I think Martin Crowe's got through the stickiest patch, and he's starting to go up a gear.
Five fours. And a little under 2¾ hours in the making. Too short. Been a problem certainly after lunch with the South African bowlers.
What command of stroke. Once you pull in front of square, then you're in control. It brings up the 200. And this fourth 50 has come in just 10.
In swing and with the swing through mid wicket. I think it might go. It does. And another milestone in the great Martin Crowe's cricket career. And the big electronic scoreboard here at the Wanderers, a splendid addition to this ground, brings 19,000 first class runs. Only two other New Zealanders have scored more than that. What an average for first class cricket, 56.39. Unbelievable.